Oh, hi there. Anyone know what this robot is called? And what it can really do? Well, stay with me, and you might just be impressed.
Welcome to Smart Robots Review.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Smart Robots Review, the show that reviews consumer robotics and fantastic tech from around the world. I'm your host, Elias. Great to have you here. And as always, we have a new robot to talk about. This is the OZOBOT Bit 2.0. Funny little name, OZOBOT. Made by a company called Evolve with two L's. I like it. So it's a micro robot. Clearly a STEM toy or teaching tool, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. But what can it really do? All right, so I have a white piece of paper here with a black line drawn across it. I'm going to turn on the OZOBOT and place it at the beginning of the black line. Watch as it follows the black line, not unlike industrial AGV robots that follow typically some colored line on the floor, or a cable, or some magnets. Interesting. But there's more to this. All right, now I have three more lines on the piece of paper, a blue, green, and red one. I'm going to turn on the OZOBOT again, place it on the blue line. That's interesting. It follows the line, and it shows a blue light on top. So let's put it on the green one. Same thing. And red, I'm assuming, there you go, here's a red color. So, you guessed it, the OZOBOT can read colors. But how does it do it? Let's take a closer look. Okay, so here we have, under the OZOBOT, five lights. And without getting too technical, this is actually an array of phototransistors that are picking up light within the visible spectrum. The middle sensor is a sensor that can recognize colors. The rest of the lights provide contrast for the OZOBOT to tell where the lines are. That's interesting. But there's a lot more to the OZOBOT than just following lines and reading colors. You can actually give it commands. You can program it using its own color code language. And since it was designed for children 8 and up, you can imagine that actually programming it is not all that difficult. Let's start by looking at the applications that are available for the OZOBOT Bit in the App Store and the Google Android Store. First, with the OZOBOT app. So this app is used to calibrate the OZOBOT to its optimum settings so that it can recognize colors accurately and perform as expected. So you go to the OZOBOT tune-up, hold the power button for 2 seconds until there's a white blinking light, place it in the middle, and press the calibrate sensors button. And you can see that right away it flashed green, which means it completed the calibration of its sensors. Let's go back to the main function of this application, which is called OZODraw. Here I'm going to click start. There's 3 choices, and let's start with free draw. And remember what I showed you earlier with the lines. We have a blue line, a red line, green, and black. I'm going to place the OZOBOT on the blue line. Look at that, it sees blue. Same thing with the red, green, and black. Excellent. All right, so now let's clear this out. It's very easy. And let's add some complexity. So I'm gonna do a black line. I'm going to add now a color code. I'm going to tell it to move fast. And then I'm going to continue the black line. This is poorly drawn. All right, let's move. And watch, I'm gonna place the OZOBOT here. It's going to read the code and move fast. Look at that, love that, all right. So then let's add more complexity. Let's add a spin move over here, and I'm going to even change the color of the line, make it turn. I'm gonna go over here. There we go. It's going to start. It's going to go move fast. It's going to change its main color because it sees blue. And it's going to spin. Now, we have reviewed other robots that come with applications with block-based type of programming. Easy to use, easy to learn. Now, the OZOBOT Bit 2.0 takes this concept into a new level with a web-based program called OZOBlockly, which is a free, easy to access using any browser editor that allows your child to learn programming concepts using the block programming method at a pace they can handle. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so let's start with a simple program. So we have the different levels here. Okay, so this is interesting. Let's do some kind of movement. Let's do a zigzag. So we'll pick a zigzag movement. We'll tell the OZOBOT to move in a zigzag pattern and pick the speed as slow. Then to download the simple program to the OZOBOT, and this is where it gets unique, the OZOBOT receives the commands via pulses of light. You place the OZOBOT on the screen. The commands are downloaded. That's so cool. And then to execute the command, you can place it on any surface. You double click the power button and there you go. It's executing a zigzag move pattern. Okay, so far we're barely scratching the surface of how powerful OZOBlocky can be with OZOBOT. Let's do another quick example. How about we change the light on top of the OZOBOT to green, add a pause. Okay, how about 2 seconds? And let's add a spin to the left and maybe some police lights. Oh, and we can pop it right between those 2 steps. Okay, let's try this out. It's green and it's moving a zigzag pattern. It's going to pause for 2 seconds. Then the police light pattern, and then a spin. Nice. Now, so far we've been exposed to sequential type programming, very simple programming, but I will show you why OZOBlockly and OZOBOT can be more effective and take your children's learning to the next level. OZOBlockly will introduce your kids to loops and logic, creating variables and setting up functions. Commonly used in every mainstream programming language and something you will not find as a feature in the applications of other robots we have reviewed so far. And if you need help, there's plenty of help built in, examples you can access right from the application, and more resources are available on the website. Whether you're a kid playing with OZOBOT and this is your favorite toy, or a parent working with your child to teach them the basics of programming, or a teacher who is focused on using this in an organized classroom learning effort. Well, I promise I will not get too technical here, but for those of you that are interested, at the heart of the OZOBOT Bit 2.0, there's an Atmel ATmega 328, a high-performance yet power-efficient 8-bit RISC architecture microcontroller with 32 kilobytes of flash memory and a maximum clock of 20 megahertz. Now, I don't know if Evolve is running it at 20 megahertz or not. They could not provide me that information, but it's interesting at least to know. Also, it has a lithium polymer, very small battery that charges relatively quick and lasts about an hour. The twin micro motors give the OZOBOT Bit 2.0 a speed range between 15 to 85 millimeters per second. So don't expect to break any land records, but the drive is precise and relatively quiet. The OZOBOT Bit 2.0 that I used today came in a starter pack, and that includes markers, a calibration sheet, a reference sheet for the codes, some activities and accessories to accessorize the OZOBOT, including a couple of skins that look like this. So what we have here is a micro-sized marvel. Combined with its applications, the OZOBOT Bit 2.0 is a great empowering or teaching tool for young minds to learn the basics of computer science, be exposed to concepts like physics and mathematics. It is very reasonably priced at about $50 to $60. It comes with some necessary accessories here. Even if you don't have a tablet, you can use a piece of paper and the markers to take advantage of its teaching capability. So, you know what I think about the OZOBOT Bit 2.0. What do you guys think? The opinion that always matters is your opinion. So please let me know in the comments below what you guys thought about today's episode, what you thought about the OZOBOT Bit 2.0. If you do have one, I'd love to hear how you use them and how you like it, or how you maybe you don't like it. The same company also makes another robot called the Evo. I'd love to take a look at that one as well. Certainly, they did a great job with the OZOBOT Bit. Anyway, until next time, thank you for watching Smart Robots Review.